afternoon. This is WMNF Tampa, and it's time for the live music showcase. My name is Randy, and I'll be trying to get this show set up for you and tell you about it. We've got time to talk about it for a few minutes before we go into action with the Eilen Jewell Band. This vintage live music showcase goes back to 2007. We cannot do any live music in the station for a while because we're kind of on a lockdown with just a handful of staff running the station. And we can't bring our very talented live crew in for their... We got audio people. We got people mixing the sounds and all that stuff. And we just can't do it all. So we're playing vintage shows. And we found this one with the Eilen Jewell Band back in 2007. We thought this would be a good one to play because Eilen Jewell was scheduled to headline the 2020 Americana Fest, which was supposed to take place last month. And obviously... it's not happening. This set from 2007 was the station and Tampa Bay's introduction to Eilen Jewell. She was coming to town opening two shows for Chuck Prophet, who was quite popular at that time. He still is, but at that time he was doing two shows when he came to town. The Friday night was at the State Theater. The Saturday night was going to be at Skipper's. And so we brought her in on Friday for the live music showcase. And we had never heard her before. Chuck Prophet's booking agent had suggested that she open for Chuck, and we didn't know that much about her, but we listened to her CD, and it sounded pretty good. So we booked her, and we had her in on the show, and this was our introduction. And if you were listening, it was at that time, it was your introduction to the Eilen Jewell Band, and we found out how she put that great band together. We didn't expect such a great band. And we found out how such a young person could get into so much old music and really appreciate it and be able to celebrate it. So, are you ready to hear the Eilen Jewell Band? The date, November 16th, 2007, 12 and a half years ago. This was the live music showcase. And we're going to get it going right here on 88.5 WMNF Tampa.
Oh,
What a great band you have, Eilen.
Thank you. I like them, too.
It's going to be great to see this band live if you come to Skipper Smokehouse tonight or the State Theater tomorrow night. We've got that upright bass. Is that,
yeah, that's Johnny Shasha there.
Hello.
Hey, Johnny. that's a tough thing to travel around with, a big thing like that, Johnny.
Yes, it is. It's awful.
Do you play strictly the upright, or do you have another bass at home that you sometimes
dabble with? I do a strictly upright bass. I don't even own electric.
So, Eilen, is that really a requirement for your band that you'd only have an upright, and why?
Gosh, that's a good question. I don't know. I think that what we do just it fits better with an upright. We kind of do kind of a more, I don't know, western swingish, rockabilly-ish kind of early country thing, and for the most part they were all doing upright bass back then, so it's kind of a requirement. Yeah.
I love it. Tell me how you got into all this old music. You're how old are you? 28.
Yeah,
and so, you know, you were born, you know, 1979.
That's
something
right.
Like that.
Wow.
And you're playing music from the 40s, or stylistically from the 40s, 50s, 60s.
Mm-hmm.
How did that happen? How'd you find all this old music?
Let's see. I guess my first exposure to it was through my father. He was a Howlin' Wolf fan, and that kind of opened the doors. Well, Bob Dylan, he kind of exposed me to Bob Dylan. So Bob Dylan is sort of a gateway musician to a lot of
earlier
stuff.
Was this music your parents were playing for themselves and you just heard it, or did you go looking through their record collection and discover these things?
Well, it was a little of both. With Howlin' Wolf, I discovered the old record in the collection. I think our record player, we had one for a while, it broke at some point and we just never really replaced it. But we still had the record collection. So when I became a teenager, I was kind of fascinated by I don't know, like, who's this guy named Howlin' Wolf, and why do we have this record of him?
So you got a record player then, and
yeah, from a yard sale I found one, and I kind of dug through and decided what I liked of, you know, from his collection.
And then so you had Bob Dylan, and what Bob Dylan album?
It was Bringing It All Back Home. I think we had Nashville Skyline as well. Uh-huh. Either that or I bought that at another yard sale.
And then how'd you find your way into country music?
Kind of also through Bob Dylan. Bob Dylan's bootleg series is what my dad played for us on a long family car trip. And Bob Dylan references Woody Guthrie a lot in the bootleg series. He even has a poem, it's a tribute to him, that he reads. And so I was curious about who Woody Guthrie was, and he's considered more folk, but to me it's kind of similar. Like, once you get into Woody Guthrie, you got to get into Hank Williams, and to me they're kind of all in the same family. So I sort of followed all the little branches everywhere, and now here I am.
Here you are, and you're writing songs that sound like they, you know, they could have been written in 1956.
Oh, thanks. That's what I listen to, so it's I guess that's how it comes across.
Can we hear another one?
Sure. Let's do. You guys want to do In the End? Yeah. This is another one from the new record. How you Thank you.
Eilen, your guitar is autographed by Loretta Lynn.
Oh, yeah. So it is. It says, love you, Loretta Lynn. She's a sweetheart.
I understand you opened a show for her.
Yeah, that's right. It was
and the reviews I read were that you just about stole the show.
Oh, I wouldn't say that. No one can steal the show from Loretta.
Well, a standing ovation, that kind of stuff for an opening act is amazing. But,
yeah, we were very flattered by that. That was really great.
Your road to getting a CD out was fraught with some difficulties, as I understand it. You lost your first album in a fire?
Yeah, that was before this makeup of the band. There was a slightly different personnel involved, and we went to record it, and we actually had the whole thing recorded and mixed. I think it was just about done and ready to be mastered, and the studio where we recorded it burned down to the ground, and we lost every last thing. It was really tragic, you know, for the producer owned the studio. It was kind of next to his house. And
that was a band that you had then and you'll never have again. And
yeah.
Are the songs appeared on your recent records?
Not really. Uh-huh. I don't think there were, maybe there were a couple that I recorded later, but I actually don't really remember.
So after that happened, what was your next move? I mean,
I kind of had to reassess, I guess. And I kind of realized that what we had recorded wasn't exactly what I wanted to be doing. So I went back to the drawing board in a way and started experimenting with playing with different people. I learned a lot in that process. And somewhere in there, I started playing with Johnny here, and when it was time to record Boundary County, Johnny suggested having Jerry on board, and it kind of clicked after that. Once we recorded that first one, Boundary County, the real first one, or the one that survived, we started playing together as a quartet after that.
And Boundary County was a self-release that
mm-hmm. We released that ourselves.
It got out pretty much nationally, but how much did Boundary County get out? We got it here at the radio station, so I can't tell if anybody else got it. You know, did other people get that album?
Well, some of them did. It wasn't as widely distributed as the second one, Letters from Sinners and Strangers,
which is on Signature Sounds.
Right.
It's a real label release, and you've gotten some promotion with that. Boundary County is a terrific release. You know, came out, it slipped by me, and I listened to it maybe 6 months later, and I had it on my iPod, and every time the songs would come on, I'd go, wow, that's a good one.
Oh, thank you.
You know, really, really good.
Thanks.
Good work on Boundary County, and the new one is...
Letters from Sinners and Strangers.
Continues.
Oh, so, good. Thank you.
So we're seeing your star rise.
Cool.
More people need to hear you. The show tonight is at Skipper Smokehouse, tomorrow night at the State Theater. The Eilen Jewell Band is in the studio with us this morning. Can we get another song?
Sure. How about High Shelf Booze? This is another one from our new record.
A one, two, let's go.
Tell him I've gone, meet all the girls and drink all that
The Eilen Jewell Band live on the WMNF Live Music Showcase, Friday mornings, 9 a.m. I'm really enjoying the tasty guitar playing from Jerry.
Yeah, Jerry, it's Jerry Miller there.
You want to lean into that mic, Jerry, and tell people your background and where you've, who you've played with? Slide right into that mic.
Okay. I just played around Boston for years and years, and I grew up in Nashville, Tennessee, so I... You know, played a lot of country music over the years. So,
just playing some really great licks over there.
Well, thanks.
You should come see this band tonight. They'll be at Skipper's Smokehouse in the State Theater in St. Petersburg tomorrow night. The show starts about 8 o'clock, and we have tickets available at WMNF. You can call 813-238-8001. You can get them at WMNF outlets, or you can go to WMNF.org. Eilen, these songs that you write, are you thinking about other artists? Like, are you sitting down to write a song thinking, this is how Charlie Rich would write it, or this is how Hank would write it, or this is how Dylan would write it? Or do you, or have you just kind of internalized all that old music so that it just comes out as you?
I think it's more of an internal process. I never set out to write anything in a particular way, you know, or after a particular style of writing. But sometimes when I'm writing a song, I think, oh, this reminds me of, you know, something that maybe I heard, or, you know, it's kind of a something that I see in hindsight. Like, oh, yeah, I see where I got that. And sometimes a line will come to me and I'll write it down, and then I'll think, oh, that's really similar to, like, for example, a Jimmy Rogers song, like, Where They Never Say Your Name. That line was from one of his songs where he says something like, I want to go somewhere where I can't hear them call your name, or something like that. I think they just kind of, different lines from different songs that I love sort of trickle into my subconscious or something, and I filter through them in my own way without really noticing, and then they appear in my songs in different ways.
You do put covers in your repertoire, although I have to say they aren't super familiar covers. But
yeah.
What are your thoughts on that, and why do you choose the songs you choose?
I feel like that's also a
And since
fairly...
you have on Letters, you have Eric Anderson's Dusty Boxcar Wall.
Yeah.
I mean, where do your covers come from?
That's also a fairly passive process, I think. I feel like they kind of come to me just various ways. I guess listening to music, you know, something will just stand out. I'm not sure why, and it'll kind of bug me until I try to play it, and you know, it'll say like. It'll be the kind of this nagging thing in the back of my mind saying, play me. And if I do play it and, you know, perform it live and it clicks and it just feels right, then it's something that will stay in the repertoire. And so the Charlie Rich song, Thanks a Lot, worked that way. And Walking Down the Line is a Bob Dylan song. I've been playing that one for years. And so they all kind of have that in common, I guess. And it tends to be... more rare songs too, because I think that they just they hit me harder for some reason. I think I haven't heard them so many times that I've kind of tuned them out. You know, like a lot of the big hits, I've heard them so many times that they're not as fresh to me as something that I've never heard. And those are the ones that I kind of latch on to, I think.
Can we hear another one?
Sure. Should we do one of those covers?
Yeah.
We could do Dusty Boxcar, or I guess we could do Thanks a Lot. What do you guys want? Yeah. Dusty Boxcar, okay.
Old Eric Anderson song, done here by the Eilen Jewell Band.
Yeah.
Old songs and you make them sound contemporary. You've got a great gift, Eilen.
Thank you.
I want to thank the engineers in our little show today, Mark Perfetti, Steve and Duengo, Ryan Oreskovich, and Nell Abram, and getting some great sound this morning. So, Eilen, since Letters from Sinners and Strangers came out in the summer for national release, what has been happening with you in your career? You've been out on the road. What's the reaction been?
We've been touring almost nonstop since then.
Where have you been?
We've been all over the South, and we're about to head out to the West Coast. We made it out as far as Idaho over the summer and did a hometown kind of reunion show there. And We got into the Midwest a bit, and we've been up and down the East Coast. And Jason Beek here is the drummer, and he does the backup singing here. He and I went over to Europe and did a lot of radio appearances. And in the spring, we're going to go back as a trio and then as a quartet to play some live shows. So
on this tour, have you been mostly doing opening or co-billing kind of deals, or you've been playing your own, heading your own shows?
This particular tour?
Yes.
We've been doing mostly opening shows and radio appearances, but last night we did a full show.
What kind of people do you open for? Besides Loretta Lynn and Chuck Prophet, those are the ones we know about.
Help me out here, guys. It's early.
All over the place. We opened up for the Holmes Brothers in D.C., and we've opened up for... you've opened up for Chris Smithers as a duo. It's sort of run the gamut. In the Americana folky bracket, if you will.
And how's the CD doing?
Well, we don't have a whole lot to compare it to, but the powers that be at Signature Sounds say that it's doing well.
They're happy with it.
Yeah,
well, I see they just put out a follow-up EP.
Yeah, that's right.
And tell us about that. It's got a Billie Holiday song on it.
Yeah, it has two songs that were previously unreleased and one that was only released as a B-side to our... We have this little 45 vinyl out there, and it was the B-side to that. It's an old blues song called Nobody's Business. And so it's those three songs plus Heartache Boulevard from our new record and The Flood from our first record. Five songs. It's going to be available on our website pretty soon.
Are you going to be selling CDs tonight and tomorrow night?
Oh, yeah.
All of them? All three?
Yeah, all three and the little vinyl. And we got T-shirts and stickers.
The whole merchandise.
Yeah.
That package, huh?
I'm a real traveling sales girl.
What are you guys traveling in?
We travel around in an 8-passenger van, and we somehow managed to squeeze in there.
Who drives?
Me and Jason, for the most part. And sometimes Johnny when we're about to lose our minds.
I think last night the autopilot drove us to
Yeah, these guys did a... How late did the show go last night in Jacksonville?
I think we were out of there by 11.
Yeah, it's not too bad.
Not too bad, but we pulled in. I think we were in our hotel room by 3 a.m. Not too bad, you know.
Well, we'll let you go home and sleep after you finish your set, but we still have to get a couple more songs out of you.
Okay. We should do one from the first record. How about Boundary County? Say hello to Boundary County if you make it up that way. I don't get around as much as I did in my younger days. I was raised in that country, so pure and so fair. But I took too hard to the whiskey, wandered away from there. Wander away from there. Well, I miss the barbed wire and the sage on that wild northern range. A giant staring sky, like a bright tragic blue eye. Why I left, I can't say why. I can't say why. Say hello to Boundary County for me. She's prettier than dreams. And if you've been someplace so far away, then you've really seen some things. Well, those miles and miles of steel rail are a one-way track. And no matter how hard I try, I never make it back. I never make it back. I miss those violet hills and the sweet smell of the fields. Reach their arms out so wide, like hell. Heaven's only bride. Why I left, I can't say why. I can't say why.
The Eilen Jewell Band live here on WMNF 88.5 and WMNF.org worldwide on the web. Eilen, I'd never classify you as a topical songwriter, but on both of your albums, you have one song on Boundary County. You have The Flood, which is a powerful song about Hurricane Katrina. And on the new album, you have How Long, which mm-hmm. sets a Martin Luther King speech to mm-hmm. music, basically. What are your thoughts on putting topical music into your repertoire?
Well, honestly, I don't really see either one of them as topical, just because I guess that wasn't my intention in writing them. I think to me, the process of writing them was really no different from writing any other song. They're both of the lyrics in them and there's just everything about them, that the subject and everything is so personal to me, and as emotional as, you know, a heartbreak or, you know, something that happens in your personal life. They both kind of deal in a way with racism. Well, The Flood is very directly about racism, and to me, that's it's always just been something that is, it's just in me as one of those things that it's a very personal topic. And so it felt the same. And I really wasn't thinking of it as a political thing, or I wasn't trying to make a statement with it. Afterwards, of course, you know, I can see how it's been taken that way. But, you know, it's, to me, it's, yeah, it's just like anything else that happens in your life. You know, it's a, it hits you in the same way.
Do you have plans for a new record coming out next year, or what's on your radar?
Yeah, well, we're not sure about next year, but we're gonna get working on it as soon as possible here. It still feels like Boundary County just came out to me. It's been such a wild ride, and time has flown by really quickly. And I guess if not 2008, then 2009 for sure.
Are you thinking about doing anything with Boundary County to get it out more places, since people know about you more now?
I think that Signature Sounds is going to release it on with their label on it. Is that right? Where they're thinking about it?
Jim's scratching his head in Northampton, Massachusetts. Yeah, well, you know, Boundary County was sort of the album that got Signature Sounds' attention in the first place. They heard it, they agreed to sell it on their website, and they sent it out to, you know, some radio stations and whatnot, and which is how you folks ended up with it. So I think eventually it would, hopefully it'll be distributed through Signature. Hey, Jim?
Is he listening?
Probably.
I think we have time for one or two more. We've got about 8 minutes, so go
okay.
For it.
Let's do another one from Boundary County. Let's do Gotta Get Right.
Eilen Jewell Band live here in the studio at WMNF. They're going to be at concert tonight at Skipper's Smokehouse, tomorrow night at the State Theater. You can catch a rising star. Seeing them is a treat. Some really great musicians in the band here, and this is really a first-rate musical group. We're honored that you have come to Tampa to visit with us, and we look forward to seeing you tonight.
Thank you.
I think we have time for one more song. We might be fading out with the news at 10:01, but we can go right into it, and the people on the archive will be able to listen to the whole song. Okay, we sometimes do that, Eilen. We keep these shows on the Internet Archive.
Okay.
And sometimes we do a bonus track after 10 o'clock. So.
Okay.
So let's go.
All right, well, here's let's do Nobody's Business.
Jewell Band. This is the WMNF Live Music Showcase. Thank you for listening. This is WMNF Tampa, 88.5, WMNF.org. And I hope you realize that was 13 years ago that that happened, just about. November 16th, 2007 is when Eilen Jewell made her first appearance for WMNF and was on the live music showcase. She went on to play that night at Skipper's and the next night at the State Theater. She has come back many times, one or two tropical heat waves, one of those alt country hoedowns that was a sellout at Skipper's that we've done a couple times. She's played several of her own headline shows at Skipper's, and she was scheduled to headline this year's Americana Fest this spring that got derailed by the coronavirus. We do have time to play a new song by her that they sent us. The tune is A Satisfied Mind, and Jason Beek, the drummer, and her husband writes, "The tune is A Satisfied Mind and was recorded last summer with Eilen's road band of Jerry Miller on guitar, Matthew Murphy on bass, and yours truly on the cans. This is a song that we have performed with our country gospel side project, the Sacred Shakers, for many years. We finally recorded this beautiful song in the studio. The song has been covered by a variety of well-known artists, from Porter Wagoner to Bob Dylan to The Byrds to Lucinda Williams, but it was time for Eilen to put her own stamp on it officially. And so we're going to check that out right now. It's a beautiful song called A Satisfied Mind. Thank you. Well, I hope you've enjoyed this hour of Eilen Jewell's music from 2007, and that right there is brand new, a new single from her. And thank you so much for tuning in, and we love you for your support of WMNF during our Giving Newsday and during our Sarasota News Challenge last week, and thank you so much.